you have to look at the global pie, right? So why should we attack the building? So the building, it's about 1/5 of the energy on our planet, which goes into these buildings. And when you look at building, they've been built and they're going to stay there for 20, 50, and even 60 years in some cases. And they will be consuming day after day the energy. And the way that building are controlled today, it's purely reactive.
By 2060, 2/3 of the world's expected population of 10 billion will live in cities. To accommodate this growth, experts expect that we'll need to add nearly 2.5 trillion square feet of global building stock. That's the equivalent of adding a New York City to the map every month for 40 years. But considering that today buildings are responsible for upwards of 40% of global emissions, the world won't come close to meeting its environmental goals unless we find a way to make buildings cleaner and smarter. Luckily, Jean-Simon Venne and his team at Brainbox AI in Montreal, Quebec, are working at the cutting edge of artificial intelligence to create a solution.
Brainbox AI, we're using the AI technology, and more precisely the deep learning part of the AI technology, to apply to the HVAC, which is the heating and cooling ventilation of building, to optimize that energy which is spent by the system. And we do it in a way that we're using this capability of the AI of predicting what will be happening to finding what is the best optimal control strategy for each building all at the same time. Using deep learning technology, similar than the autonomous car or the autonomous truck, we see the future. We use that prediction capability of neural network to see what will be happening in the next seconds, the next minute, or even the next hours. So we basically see the future. So we see it's going to be a bit too hot in 50 minutes or in an hour in this room. And instead of just letting it happening and then it's become too hot, and then you make a correction action to bring the temperature back down, we start to make some micro adjustment in advance and we change that future. So it's very similar than the movie Back to the Future, where we go in the future, we see how horrible it is. Then we come back in the present, we make some very small adjustment, barely noticeable. And then you go back in the future and you see, oh, that did the trick, right? That changed entirely. Now we have a better future. We're reaching now 100 million square feet deployed in 17 countries, 70 cities across the world. One of the countries where we have the many, many buildings deployed is in Australia. But it goes from Australia to Italy to Ireland to, of course, the United States, Canada. So it's already spread and it's growing very fast. So we could have decided, you know, to hire the people, build a team internally at Brainbox and develop this technology. It would have taken a lot of time, time that we don't have. So we really adopt this strategy of we're going to decentralize the production, the development, the design of each of the components. So we identified several components and said, we're going to create these co-research with several universities.
So I started doing an internship in the energy storage environment. And so my Mitacs really allowed me to pursue that industrial path in parallel to my academic background. And then as I continued into my master's in computer science and later into my PhD in energy systems, artificial intelligence, that's when I had the opportunity to meet Brainbox. And this is where actually it allowed me to build a professional network. So really expand on the professional network, connect with a lot of great mentors, be it on the managerial, teamwork perspective, or even technical skills in general. And today I'm really doing my PhD in parallel with Brainbox. So it's a collaborative partnership with their Swarm AI project. So for us as a researcher, it allows us to go from virtual testing and pure simulation to bring it to the real world. So that's what Brainbox is all about. And that's where the huge value is for us to really apply state of the art in terms of research and control, but directly into the real world and having an impact with real buildings.
So imagine that you have all of these AI agents which are operating each of the building in real time. If you start to mesh these agents together and they start to collaborate to create that school of fish that I described, this is the pivotal moment. So this when everything changed. At that point, everything changed. And the beauty of it is the first time when the evolution of the technology that we could do this now. So we, for the first time, have the capability to do it, thanks to the computer capacity in terms of CPU capacity, storage costs, but also all of these neural networks. So putting all this together, giving us that kind of a collaboration of independent AI agent working together for the greater good of the planet. So that's what we're working with, Miguel.
The collaboration with the professor is very important because, you know, what we are doing with Mitacs is like we are making connections between companies, industry, and academia. And this is the most important part. The company at the end, like Brainbox, they have connection now with several universities coast to coast in Canada. And this is fantastic. And the interns, they are talent, they are very good, they have good knowledge, but they represent the connection between the industry and the academia. What we say all the time, we are using them, they are the human bridges between university. They are doing a great job, it's fantastic, but still they are making stronger the relationship between academia and industry. And this is very important, you know, for our Canada, for our technology, for our industry, we need to have this talent. And companies like Brainbox AI, they understood that and they are using that. It's fantastic.
So the goal here is to save the energy, save these events which are happening in the building about it's a bit too cold, it's a bit too hot, and then people are not comfortable. So we want to eliminate these things. At the same time, we want to reduce the emission, right? So there's the energy and the cost of the energy, but then there's the emission too you want to save. And that is a huge impact. So we will reduce up to 40% of the emission of a given building by doing that modulation, because we know the future. So you need to deploy that technology extremely rapidly. You need to scale it up very fast everywhere in the world so you could create that inflection point. So of course, people on the transportation and the industrial side will need to do their part. But on the real estate side, on the building side, which is, you know, a big chunk of that pie, if you want to contribute and make that inflection point for the planet, you need to distribute that technology very fast.